ശ്രീമാൻ വെങ്കടനാഥാര്യ കവിതാർക്കിക കേസരി വേദാന്താചാര്യവര്യോ മേ സന്നിധത്താം സദാഹൃദി. സോ വിൽ കണ്ടിന്യൂ വിത്ത് യമുനാചാര്യസ് സ്തോത്രരത്നം. വി ഹാഡ് ദ ഇൻവക്കേറ്ററി വേഴ്സസ് ദ തനിയൻസ് യെസ്റ്റർഡേ. സോ ടുഡേ വി വിൽ സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ഓഫ് വിത്ത് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് വേഴ്സ്. ലെറ്റ് മീ ബിഗിൻ വിത്ത് കോഷ്യസ് The trepidations, the translation, the crude translation with the lack of qualification or proficiency in both languages, English as well as Sanskrit. Adiyan starts this dreadful task, a wonderful Stotra Ratnam of Yamunacharya, based on an extensive great commentary by Sri Uttamaswamy in Tamil. This is Sri Uttamaswamy had blessed us with a beautiful Vyakhyanam in Tamil, simple Tamil, based on Swami Desikan's Stotra Ratna Bhashyam and Paramakarunika Acharya Periyavachan Pillai Stotra Ratna Vyakhyanam. So Perumal blessed through the Alvars, through the Mayarvaram Madinala Marulinan. The Alvars were blessed with the right jnanam in their mind, crystal clear jnanam, because of Perumal's Nirhetuka Kripai. And because of that jnanam, which culminated into Bhakti Rupa Panna jnanam, and they had Parabhakti, Parajnana, Paramabhakti, intense thwarai to attain Perumal, and they immersed themselves in Bhagavad Gunanubhavam. And they blessed us with the wonderful Sri Suktis, Alvar Sri Suktis. They asked for Valuvila Adimai, the blemishless eternal Kaikariyam at the lotus feet of Perumal. And they finally attained the Sri Vaikuntham Mokshanubhavam, Avavatri Veedu Petru. Their desire were completely fulfilled and they attained the Moksham. Thus, the Kaikarya Ruchi was enjoyed by the Acharyas and Alavandar as Alvar Prasadam consumed these wonderful Sri Suktis. And because of Acharya Upadesa Kramam, Alavandar enjoyed this Dramidopanishad Ragasyartham, and he had that Anusanthanam of Alvar Acharya Sri Suktis of his grandfather Sriman Nathamuni through his own acharyas. And because of that, he had Anubhava Parivaham, the spilling of wonderful Anubhavam, and he did not want to enjoy by himself, and he took pity on samsaris like us, and he wanted to get us rid of the samsaric afflictions and blessed us with the wonderful Sri Stotram, Stotra Ratnam, which is essentially an essence of Vedantam, an essence of Bhagavad Kalyana Gunanubhavam, the essence of Nammalvas Thiruvayamuri, and everything. So in order to clarify and clear the Paratattvam, the supreme entity of Sriman Narayanan, the Paramahitam, the supreme means, the way, and the Paramapurushartham, the ultimate goal, the end, the destination to the people, and make them to be the blessed recipients of Perumal's grace by these wonderful stotram. And hence he came out with these stotrams. Thereby he establishes the unambiguous, unparalleled supremacy of Sriman Narayanan, and thus clearing our doubts thereby. And he establishes the Prabhati Margam, and then finally he clarifies that how one can enjoy the Kalyana Gunanubhavam. And so he blesses us with the 65 verses of Stotra Ratnam. He starts off his verse with Acharya Anusandhanam by contemplating on his Acharya's glories, and he Alavanda starts off meditating and praising on Sriman Nathamuni with three verses, the first, second and third, with three verses, and on Acharya, who removed the weeds of other religions and established the Paramartham, the Sri Vaishnava doctrine, in philosophical aspects as well as religious aspects. He is the one, Nathena Muninathena, says Swami Desikan. Without him, we would have become anathars. Without that Nathan, we all would have been orphans. So, says Swami Desikan, can anyone pay his obeisance to Acharya without starting off first on his own Acharya, who is Manakkal Nambi himself? And the Shastra says, when Acharya and Pracharya, both of them are together, one needs to first prostrate to the Pracharya and then only the Acharya. In this case, even that does not arise. Manakkal Nambi was not there, nor Sriman Nathamuni. When Acharya himself is not in the front, one can surely start off with Pracharya, of course. So, Lakshmi Natha Samarambam, Natha Yamana Madhyamam, Asmad Acharya Pariyantam, Vande Guru Parampara. So, we can start off from there. But the fact is, Alavanda never mentioned about Manakkal Nambi in this stotram. Sri Uttama Swami adds, saying that, is there any compulsion about it? For example, Alavanda talks about Namalvar in Stotra Ratnam. So, what about other Alvars? Alavanda talks about sage Parasarar in verse 4. What about other rishis? He touches upon the key ones probably with a reason. Similarly, here he talks about Acharya Nathamuni. Further, in order to get Acharya Sambandham, Sriman Nathamuni is the one who wanted to get his grandson back on track. And hence, it's obviously Yamunacharya pays his gratitude to Sriman Nathamuni. It is because of Pracharya Sambandham, Sriman Nathamuni Sambandham, the first and foremost, he was the grandfather, and he is the one who told Ramamishra Manakkal Nambi to follow the instruction and niyamanam of Acharya Sriman Nathamuni through Uyyakondar. And because thus Alavandar was brought back to the light of our Sampradayam from his royal life because of Swami Manakkal Nambi. And what happened when our Alavandar was a king, about which you know the story. Alavandar had become the king, and he could not attend to spiritual pursuits because he was taking care of the kingdom. And so he immersed himself in the king's duties, royal duties. And meanwhile, Manakkal Nambi was trying to catch Yamunacharya's attention, the king's attention, to fulfill his commitment and promise to his Acharyan to get back and install Alavandar as the spiritual successor to Sriman Nathamuni. So Sriman Nathamuni had already declared that Alavandar would become the Acharyan in the Acharya lineage, but he could not meet Alavandar, being a king, to discuss about this matter. So he came out with an idea. He came to know that the king relishes the kind of spinach, Thooduvalai Keerai. So he supplied that spinach nicely cooked, or in order for the king's cooks to cook that spinach. So he gave that spinach to the royal kitchen daily. After a few months, after supplying every day the spinach, he stopped one day. So the king asked the cook as to why the spinach is not being served these days. It was being served for a few months. Why not now? So they all replied, saying that one Brahmin used to supply every day and he does not come nowadays. Alavandar was wondering, can you bring him next time when you see him? So next day he brought, and immediately they brought him in front of the king. So Ramamishra Manakkal Nambi immediately told Alavandar that he has been instructed by his grandfather through Uyyakondar, and Sri Nathamuni had passed on the family wealth, Kula Dhanam, that needs to be handed over to the grandson as the legal heir to Sri Alavandar. Alavandar said, in that case, give me that Kula Dhanam. I am willing to accept right now. No, Swami, Raja, Maharaja, no, it's not here. Come with me. He took him all the way to Sri Rangam, Perumal Sannadhi, where Arada Arulamadam Podinda Koil. He showed Alavandar the Divya Mangala Vigraham, the Swarupa Lavanyam of Sri Ranganathan. He showed, the Acharyan showed Alavandar the wonderful in divine splendor, the divine beauty, the gorgeous Ranganathan. And when Alavandar Yamunacharya raised his head to look at Lord Ranganatha, from the feet to the head, just like Tripana Alvar saw, he had his tears rolling down his cheeks. Kariyavagi pudai parandu milirundu sevariyodiya neenda periyavaya kankal ennai peramai seidanave. Those dark, well laid out, well spread, dotted, darting, shining, ruddy lined, long, large eyes have completely stupefied me. He burst out, "I have nothing to give you, my lord. None at all. I have no qualifications. I am not religious. What a great person my grandfather was. And where am I? What am I doing? I have no one but you, the embodiment of Daya, the personification of compassion, Daya as my refuge." And then and there, it looks like he performed Saranagati at the lotus feet of Lord Ranganathan. Na dharma nishtosmi na chatma vedi na bhakti mantos charanaravinde akinchanaha aranyagati saranya tutpadamolam saranam prabadhye. And Rama Mishra explained the purpose of his mission and requested Alavandar to take over the reins of the leadership, the Acharya position, bequeathed to him by his illustrious grandfather Nathamuni. Alavandar took to sannyas and was then onwards was called as Yamunamuni. Thus, Alavandar obviously pays his obeisance to Acharya Sriman Nathamuni through these verses. So it is mentioned, it is appropriate. Thus, it is similar to Alavandar instructing Periyanambi to bring back Ramanuja to the Sampradayam. Here Nathamuni had told Uyakondar and Manakkal Nambi to bring back Alavandar to the Sampradayam. So it is the utter humility of our Purva Acharyas that Manakkal Nambi must have told Alavandar that it was Nathamuni who brought him back, and nowhere probably he would have requested Alavandar that his name should be mentioned, though Guru Parampara Anusandhanam should be recited every time with Manakkal Nambi, Nathamuni, Uyakondar, all others. So it is appropriate to mention few of Acharyas alone in Guru Parampara Anusandhanam. And one need not enlist everyone in the Acharya lineage, says Sri Uttamur Swami. So the slokas, three slokas on Sriman Nathamuni also probably may refer to his three Acharyas, Sriman Nathamuni, Sri Pundarikakshar, Sri Ramamishra, or Sriman Nathamuni, Uyakondar and Manakkal Nambi in the same order. So probably there are three verses on Nathamuni to refer to these three. Since birth, Sriman Nathamuni had been the cause, and hence the first slokam, being a Pracharya, second slokam, and his dhayai, his merciful benevolent act of the Lokopakaram for the sake of the world. Sriman Nathamuni had blessed us with the entire Divya Prabandham and also got us back Sri Shatakopa into our Acharya lineage. Thus is the third slokam. So first verse, Sriman Nathamuni is the repository of Jnana Vairagya and Bhakti, says Alavandar. Namo Chintya Adbhuta Klishta Jnana Vairagya Rashaye Nathaya Munaye Ghata Bhagavat Bhakti Sindave. Namo Achintya Adbhuta Aklishta Jnana Vairagya Rashaye Nathaya Munaye Aghata Bhagavat Bhakti Sindave. Achintya, beyond understanding. Adbhuta, Ascharyam, mysterious, marvelous, wonderful. And Aklishta, effortlessly acquired by Lord's grace. Jnana Vairagya Rashaye, personification of knowledge, detachment, together with Agada Bhagavad Bhakti Sindhave, with the deep ocean of greatest bhakti on Sriman Narayanan. Nathaya Munaye, to sage Sriman Nathamuni, Namaha, by offering prostrations, paying obeisance, paying namaskarams. So how did he ever get this jnanam? How much jnanam does he have? However many times one can analyze, one can do investigation, there is no answer, cannot be understood. Thus, the jnanam, bhakti, vairagyam, anushtanam, there is no way it can be understood. It is ati ascharyam, it's marvelous, it's excellent, never heard of or seen before. It's the rarest and hence apurvam. It is addressed as aklishtam, because it is not acquired with hard work or penance. It is effortless due to the grace of Perumal, like Sanaka, Sanat Kumaras. It's the acquisition of jnanam with complete understanding of Shastras, running nowhere haywire or running haywire towards other religions, looking for the correct philosophy. Not a single word is understood by Sriman Nathamuni in a wrong manner. Everything in tandem with Shastras, and thus it's effortless, naturally acquired. There is no decaying or change in his jnanam, consistent and coherent, not contradicting any other word in the Shastras. When one word or statement is understood, it's not in violation with other Upanishadic statements. Such a characteristic is also due to his greatest vairagyam and detachment and renunciation as well. Due to such combination of para avara tattva jnanam, he is able to take his mind away from worldly pressures and materialistic pursuits, and hence jnana vairagyam are both essentials and are found in Sriman Nathamuni as the embodiment of both of them as one lot. Thus, he has vairagyam on lower tattvams, and on paratattvam, he has such an intense love and focus with paripurna jnanam. Bhakti is flooded in his heart for Sriman Narayanan. He becomes the repository of great bhakti towards Sriman Narayanan. Saint Sriman Nathamuni, my namaskarams to you, says Alavandar wonderfully. He is called Ranganathan, and hence he is called as Nathan. He is Nathan, master for all of us. How blessed am I to be born in this family? How blessed am I to be born and to be the darling grandson of him? How blessed, what a bhagyashali I am. Enjoy Sri Alavandar on his birth as Sriman Nathamuni, as Sriman Nathamuni's grandson. కవితార్కిక సింహాయ కళ్యాణ గుణశాలినే శ్రీమతే వెంకటేశాయ వేదాంత గురవే నమః నమో నారాయణ.